Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, Studio One's Layers and Easy Comping. Layers are how you can perform different takes on the same track inside Studio One. In other DAWs, these can be called playlists, versions, or alternates. I use layers all the time because it's a fast way to record different ideas or to make sure I've got the perfect performance. One setting you want to make sure is enabled that will also help keep you organized is in the record panel. There are two ways to open this. You can click on the wrench in the transport bar near the metronome, or use the shortcut of Shift Option R on Mac or Shift Alt R on PC. In here, you'll want to make sure that Takes to Layers is enabled. Here, I have a vocal recording session I did with artist Casey Blake. While we were recording, we wanted to touch up a couple spots, and we did that with layers. Because I had Takes to Layers on, all I needed to do as the engineer was locate to the area where we wanted to punch in and hit record. Studio One recorded the new performance as a new layer. If you have a session with lots of layers or just want to comp together a stunning performance, Studio One makes it a breeze. Let's see the other takes that were put onto layers that we did with Casey. To expand layers, you could right-click on the track and choose Expand Layers, or you can use the hotkey, which I have as Control, Option, and the down arrow. This shows me all the layers or takes that I did with my artist. Here we can see the different takes that we recorded. You can rename the layers. You can also assign them a different color. Keeping your layers organized will really help when you're comping. Studio One also has a great feature that while you are in the expanded layers view, the active layer has its color highlighted and the non-active layers are grayed out. Studio One will play back the topmost layer, but what if you want to cycle through your alternate takes and grab something from another one? With the track selected, you can use the up and down arrow keys to jump between the layers. And you can use the hotkey of S to solo that take. If I want to change part of the performance with something from another take, all you have to do is highlight the area of the layer you want to promote, and Studio One does the rest. It now takes this selection and puts it to the topmost layer. You can see that it grabbed my selection from a different take because my top layer's colors have changed to the original red and the new take's blue. That's all for now. If you found this informative, please like the video or leave a comment. See you next time, and thanks for watching.